we all want close racing, but when you see riders riding so, so well as they have been, Danny Petrosian in the last two races has been magnificent. And with six to go, it would be very interesting to see how many more he can win. He's won four. That's two more than he's ever won in his MotoGP career in a season. That's right about Casey Stoner's last Grand Prix win was Malaysia in 2009.
Matt LeBlanc, again in the house. Loves his motorcycles. I think that's probably the second time this year, actually. I'm sure I saw him. I did see him definitely early on this year.
Yeah, I think Ian interviewed him earlier on.
I can't remember.
He was definitely, often see him at races, quite often in Italy, don't we?
This is the local town of Alcañiz in the province of Teruel, which is where we are. So we're about 5-10 kilometres from there. Really beautiful little town, actually. The castle sits on the top. Yeah, some people get to stay in that, not us.
No. But we're actually not complaining when we stay. We've had a nice time when we've been here.
There was all sorts of worry before we came here that, you know, it's going to be in the middle of nowhere, which it is, or there's going to be no hotels or no restaurants. Well, there's quite a lot, and there's stunning scenery around as well, and it's actually proved to be a great weekend.
Here is Casey Stoner.
He's not happy about something on his right handlebar at the moment. I'm not sure whether it's something to do with the front brake or the handlebar position. He was pointing when he came up to the grid. I don't know whether you can find anything out there, Ian, but he was just pointing to his right handlebar. Look, he's pointing it again. What's he just talking about there? He's saying just push something in a bit further.
Yeah, I think what he's saying is that he wants the throttle body moving further in on the handlebar, and that's certainly what the mechanics are doing right now here on the front of the grid.
You got really animated about that one anyway. But his first pole for Casey Stoner since the opening race of the year at Qatar, and if he wins today, it'll be his first since last year in Malaysia.
Not so many problems for Jorge Lorenzo. 7 wins this season. He's been on the podium every single race. He's got a 63-point lead in the championship. And he's had 13 successive podium finishes.
Actually, what Casey Stoner was doing there was just moving the throttle body and the brake lever so that he can brake with two fingers and not crush his forefinger on the inside of the handlebar.
It's quite a late thing to sort out, isn't it?
Not the sort of thing that happens on the grid, usually. Yeah. But maybe if they've had to rebuild that bike from this morning, if there was a handlebar malfunction, shall we say, and maybe after the crash he had, maybe that's been the problem. Because it did crash onto its right-hand side, so it could be that they've just had to reconstruct that and it's not been put into the right position.
Danny Pedrosa's looked, he's carried on where he's left off, really, in Indianapolis Misano. He's looked very, very good indeed. Okay, he's qualified third fastest, but he's on the front row of the grid. And as Gab was saying, he could have stolen pole position from Casey Stoner on that very last lap when he made a slight mistake and ran on when he was pushing very hard. And this enormous support for Danny Pedrosa here.
He remains possibly the most popular rider. Jorge Lorenzo is still massively popular, don't get me wrong. But you can hear the fans cheering. Maybe just the Danny Pedrosa stand is a lot closer to us than the Jorge Lorenzo one, but you can certainly hear that a lot more. Just having a look at some tyre changes at the front for Nicky Hayden.
Well, I tell you, while we're on the subject of tyres there, Gab, we've got the list here from Bridgestone, which shows that everybody on the grid is running the softer option rear. Now, obviously, this was done before they came out on the grid. I can tell you that the vast majority of riders have gone for the harder option front and the harder option rear for this race as the track temperature has gone up.
Yeah, it doesn't surprise me at all that that's happened. There's Nicky Hayden heading up the second row in fourth position. He's not had a podium finish yet since he was third at Indy last year. And it's only the third time in the 800s that Ducati have had two riders in the top four.
It's amazing when you look back, isn't it?
Especially when they won the championship in 2007.
Nicky Hayden, in many ways, deserves a podium. He's had a really good season. Stuck with Ducati. Ducati have stuck with him now. He's had a new 2-year contract. You would think it would be a very fruitful partnership. Certainly, of course, with Valentino Rossi and the team. Remind them of the old days, way back with the Repsol Honda days, won't it?
I'm just down on the grid now with Ben Spies. Ben, second row of the grid for the race today, but conditions very different to the conditions during practice and qualifying. Is this going to be an issue this afternoon?
Yeah, I mean, it's one of those. It's the same for everybody deals. But you know, we've had a rain session. We've had a couple sessions where it's kind of just been spitting the whole time. Now we've got, beautiful weather. I mean, it's awesome. So we can't complain right now. Is it different from what we've been in all weekend? Yeah, it's a little bit. But, you know, we're going to have some fun. Got a lot of fans out here. Like I said, great track, good weather. See if we can get a good start and put in a good race and try to stay in some good championship standings.
Well, best of luck this afternoon, Ben.
Thank you.
Ben Spies, always to the point. You get what it is, and he speaks very sensibly, as you would imagine, from the man that's done so well. Alongside him on that second row of the road, Randy Depunier. Had a fall this morning in the warm-up as well, didn't he, Randy Depunier? But I think that was more cold tyres and a major worry.
Yeah. But it will be a moment of concern for him. And Valentino Rossi just... he's off. So he's off. He's had enough. No, he's not. I think it might be a comfort break, I think they call it.
A little coming together with the local law.
No, I think they're just getting some water into his into the hump at the back there, just to give him some rehydration during the race.
He suggested he was being taken off. Good spirits, Valentino Rossi. He knows that there's no chance of retaining that world title. Looks forward to fresh passes. He'd love to win a race for Yamaha, but with the problems he's got with that shoulder, that may be very, very difficult. Although there are some circuits coming up that he really likes, aren't there, in the next five races after this one.
Yeah, it won't be easy with it's just that Pedrosa and Lorenzo have moved on so much in the time he was away.
Just down to the third row of the grid, Andrea Dovizioso. Qualified eighth fastest, but he's not a great qualifier, Andrea Dovizioso, but he's had a really good season. He is third in the championship.
It's the fifth time he's been on the third row this year, but you wouldn't expect him to be down in eighth after the end of the race.
No.
He'll be hoping. Hasn't been on the podium, though, since the British round at Silverstone. That's quite a long time ago now.
Yeah, Marco Simicelli, he is qualified ninth fastest, so on the outside of that third row. 11th in the world title for the former 250cc world champion, and he'd like to get just start climbing a little bit higher in these last six races. It was a difficult start to the season for him when he had the problems with the big crashes during testing. So the guy that surprised us, Hector Barber, done a really, really good job. He's qualified 10th, he's 12th in the world championship. He's only failed to finish one race this season. That's when his chain broke in Indianapolis.
Laguna Seca. Yeah, the last six races, been in the top 10 five times, and Laguna was the only time he missed out, and that wasn't his fault.
Really matured into MotoGP. Somebody to look out for next year.
Just a break in now. I'm just down on the grid with Randy Depunier. Randy, another exceptional qualifying performance given the injury you suffered only 9 weeks ago. Have you got the strength in the injury and the pace to run at the front in this race?
I hope it's my target. Since two races, I come back at my level about the speed. Now I need just to be consistent and to do a good race like before my injury. I think yes, will be difficult, but anyway, I will give the best. And we will see, but I'm more confident than Misano about the pace during the race.
Well, good luck this afternoon, Randy.
It's good news, isn't it?
Let's hope he does. Just saw Colin Edwards there in his 100th start for Yamaha. Also, I've just heard, he signed for Tech 3 for next year. Something I've just heard someone say when I was out in the press room. Not confirmed yet. Apparently, there'll be a press release later, but it seems he has signed for Tech 3 for next season alongside Cal Crutchlow.
Interesting combination, and nobody better for Cal Crutchlow to come into MotoGP and being alongside Colin Edwards.
So Alvaro Bautista there just in 12th position on the grid, and then Aleix Espargaró in 13th. He's not in jail, no. He'd lost his license, didn't realise that he'd lost his license because he said they hadn't sent him a note. And then, so yesterday he had to go to court to protest his innocence that when he was stopped, he shouldn't be banned from driving. So. Yeah, we'll see how that one rumbles on.
A glimpse there of Marco Melandri. Of course, Marco announced in Misano who will be leaving the championship. So, final six races for him in MotoGP. What a servant he's been.
Hiroyama in 15th place on the outside of that fifth row. And he's still, of course, recovering from that back injury. But last time out, 12th in the last two races. And there you are, you can see a Nice tribute from his to his compatriot, actually, from Mika Kallio. Of course, show you Tommy's own, everyone's thoughts. Big minute silence before the whole paddock it was down in on the pit straight. And there's Kallio on the back of the grid in 16th spot. Not being an easy weekend. And he's possibly looking a little bit towards Moto2 for next year.
There's going to be a 23-lap race. So we'll get some fireworks, eh, in the race itself. Up front row, Casey Stoner, Jorge Lorenzo and Danny Pedrosa. Many people's thoughts, events a couple of weeks ago. The crowd in great voice, look at that. I really didn't know what to expect when I came here, and I got to say, I've been very, very impressed. It'll be 5 minutes to go before the start of the race. It's going to be round 13 of the MotoGP World Championship. 23 laps of the Aragon circuit.
Away goes the safety car. And you see, you can hear the circuit announcer whooping the crowd into a bit of a frenzy. It doesn't take much, does it, in Spain, though? 70,000 people turned up today, and that's a really good attendance. We're a long, long way from big cities.
That is a fantastic attendance. There we go. Well, Nicky Hayden, extra hard front, medium rear. Ben Spies, extra hard front, medium rear. And the same also for Randy Depriniere.
Yeah, it's all the harder options anyway. So they've all gone with the harder one that they've got the option of. There's Casey Stoner on pole position on the front row of our grid. And all with the same as well. So no worries on the tyre front for all of them. They probably will be in the latter stages. Yeah. They won't be that sure about how this track will treat them. Something Danny Pedrosa alluded to yesterday in the press conference, said, well, we've never run a race here. We don't know what will happen. We don't know what kind of things, challenges this track will throw up after 23 laps. Now you can see Jorge Lorenzo, not with his usual helmet design. It's Shoya Tomizawa's helmet design. Nice tribute there from the championship leader and championship champion elect, we have to say that. 63 points. Okay, still Pedrosa and Dovizioso are in with a shout of the championship, but if he was finishing the top two, it'd be between himself and Danny Pedrosa, both of them lining up on the front row. It's in pole position. It's the Australian Casey Stoner. Can he set the cat amongst the pigeons? Can we have a non-Spanish winner in MotoGP for the first time since the opener in Qatar?
Welcome back to Aragon for round 13 of the MotoGP World Championship. I'm Nick Harris, sitting alongside me Gavin Emmett, down in pit lane, Ian Wheeler. 23 laps of this brand new circuit, 5.078 kilometres, 3.155 miles. Front row, Stoner, Lorenzo, Pedrosa.
Couldn't want it any better than that up front. Just behind them on the second row of the grid, Nicky Hayden leads it up alongside his compatriot Ben Spies and Randy Depriniere. Another great qualifying session from him.
Third row, the world champion Valentino Rossi, Andrea Dovizioso and Marco Simicelli.
All Italian looking for better results than their qualifying. Hector Barber, Colin Edwards and Alvaro Bautista on row four.
And row five, Aleixo Spargaro, Marco Melandrino, Roshi Oyama. And bringing up the rear of the field is the finish ride on that Pramac Ducati, Mika Kallio.
So 70,000 fans packing out the new Motorland Aragon circuit. There's Jorge Lorenzo, desperate to get another win in front of his home fans. Already had two this season. But Casey Stoner, first pole since he was on it in Qatar. A bit of a slipping warm-up this morning. I hope that hasn't set back his confidence. Danny Pedrosa will be full of it at the moment. Three riders all with something to go for at the front. And don't count out the riders from behind. Back of Hayden, Spies, Rossi and Dovizioso battling for that final podium spot.
Yeah, first turn, turn one's tight, and there's a very difficult turn two. So Danny Pedrosa was saying, hey, I might make really good starts, but actually getting into turn one first, it's not a great run into it from the starting grid. So it won't be as easy as perhaps it has been in other circuits.
Conditions down there, 23 degrees, 39 on track. Ian, the best we've had all weekend, but they just don't know these.
Yeah, exactly. Like you say, it's at 13 degrees higher track temperature than we've had all weekend. And it's a bit of a trip into the unknown for the MotoGP teams because they'll have no idea of tyre durability at this circuit in these conditions.
Yeah, it's going to be all right at the start, but as the race transgresses, there'll be plenty of, not anxious faces, but some very close checking up on tyre wear. We're into unknown. There are 70,124,000 fans here today. That is a really big crowd for this part of the world.
This is out of turn 13. This is where Stoner crashed this morning, just there. And then it's a right-left combination down the hill, and then it plunges for this long back straight, a kilometre long, but it's the top speeds are getting to 200 miles an hour, 328 actually from Dani Pedrosa yesterday, whereas Lorenzo down to 318. That could prove crucial in the latter stages of the race.
Well, at the end of the back straight, they come into turn 16 and 17. And you can overtake there. We won't give anything about previous results, but you can overtake there. So round 13 of the championship about to get underway.
There's Lynn Jarvis watching on from the pit wall. Seems all of Rossi's side of the garage will go, but Lorenzo's side will stay. And here comes Casey Stoner for Ducati, lining up on pole with Pedrosa on the outside, Lorenzo in the middle of that front row.
The sun is shining here in Spain. It's round 13 of the MotoGP World Championship at the brand new Aragon Circuit. Can Stoner win his first race of the season?
Held a long time on the grid, but away they go. A good start from Jorge Lorenzo. He's going to lead down into turn one. Oh, it's Pedrosa on the inside, but round goes Casey Stoner, reclaims it, and Pedrosa booked by Nicky Hayden, and he's going to lose position to Ben Spies as well. So it's Stoner leading, Lorenzo in second, Hayden up into third, Ben Spies in fourth, Lorenzo attacks.
Oh, up the inside of Casey Stoner. Danny Pedrosa almost went down. Stoner fights back side by side.
Oh, it's a great
even
start.
Now Lorenzo's going to fight back once again. What a start to the race. What a start by Nicky Hayden.
Oh, slight moment for Lorenzo. They thought about getting straight back at Casey Stoner, but Stoner was strong. He held it in there firm and no way back through for Jorge Lorenzo. They have to be so careful with those cold tyres, of course. But Danny Pedrosa would be disappointed with that one. We're used to him getting a flyer. He got off decent, but Nicky Hayden showed what he could do coming from the outside in turn one.
He's down in fifth place at the moment, Danny Pedrosa, so it wasn't a total disaster for him, but fierce stuff at the front. And Casey Stoner still leads the way. Nicky Hayden prepared to attack Jorge Lorenzo from third place. Look out also for Ben Spies. Can Hayden get through on Jorge Lorenzo? Not quite.
I just wonder if he might have a chance, though, at the end of the back straight. We know that Ducati's got the edge on power over the Yamaha. They go into 14 and 15, and it's into the long back straight, a kilometre long, for the first time on board with Jorge Lorenzo, looking back at Nicky Hayden.
Now let's have a look at these top speeds. There,
Pedrosa straight past Ben Spies. No worries whatsoever about that. And Hayden not able to,
no.
He's not closing in enough on Jorge Lorenzo. So still Stoner leads. Jorge Lorenzo half a second behind. I think the thing was for Lorenzo, he knew that Stoner's got good pace this weekend and was desperate, so desperate to get in front of him. That's why he made a couple of risky manoeuvres. But Stoner has won out and leads after the first lap. It's Lorenzo in second, Hayden in third. Now Pedrosa back into fourth, Spies in fifth. In sixth is Simoncelli ahead of Dovizioso. Rossi in eighth. Barber ninth. Tenth, Randy Depunier. Then it's Bautista, Melandri, Espargaro, Edwards, Callio and Aoyama.
One lap down. There is Ben Spies. Danny Pedrosa has got past him. Danny Pedrosa now up into fourth place at that moment at the very first turn with Nicky Hayden. Casey Stoner has got the hammer down at the front. Danny Pedrosa knows he must not let him get away too much, but he won't find it easy getting past Nicky Hayden. How many times has that situation been reversed? And we've said, you know, Hayden can't get past Danny Pedrosa, but Hayden will stand firm as he chases that first podium finish of the season.
Danny Pedrosa's start is really helping Casey Stoner. He's pulling away from Lorenzo. 0.7 the gap now between the Australian and the Mallorcan Jorge Lorenzo. In third is Nicky Hayden, and he's helping his teammate by staying in front of Danny Pedrosa. The harder he makes life for Pedrosa, although Pedrosa may well be able to go past him because it's so strong out of the corners. that Honda. I wonder if he'll have an attack. I think he will, into the back straight now, Pedrosa. But the longer he stays behind Hayden, the better it is for Stoner, who's now almost got a second lead over Jorge Lorenzo.
They come onto the back straight through turn 15. That's the gap, Stoner, Lorenzo. And here comes Danny Pedrosa again.
Now.
Whoa, Hayden, they're going to go in side by side.
No, he's ahead of him. There's no way back there for Nicky Hayden. Danny Pedrosa just cruised past him like Hayden was almost standing still. And imagine what he'll do to the Yamaha of Jorge Lorenzo when he reaches him in a lap time, because Pedrosa is having to charge through now. He can see Stoner escaping at the front. Stoner, the fastest rider on the track, a 149.862 from the Australian. He's leading by 1.1 from Jorge Lorenzo now, who will soon come under pressure from Danny Pedrosa.
There's Marco Simicelli, Andrea Dovizioso, Valentino Rossi down in eighth place. Behind him, Hector Barber and Randy Depunier, Alvaro Bautista, Marco Melandri. Colin Edwards currently running in 14th place behind Aleix Espargaró.
There's Marco Simicelli, who's got through on Andrea Dovizioso. He's in sixth, trying to keep tabs on Ben Spies at the moment. And Dovizioso, well, at the moment, Rossi not pressurising him too much. But the three Italians not battling for the positions they want to be. Sixth, seventh and eighth for Valentino Rossi.
Two and a half laps gone. The all-Italian battle still goes on with Simicelli leading the way from Dovizioso and Rossi.
At the front, the gap between Stoner and Lorenzo at 1.253 seconds. Through the next split, it's 1.5 seconds. Stoner is trying to check out. He knows how strong Pedrosa is. A slight moment for him coming through turn 13. And, 12, wasn't it? And then now he goes into 13. Pedrosa's going to get past Lorenzo on the back straight.
Because he did it to Spies. He's done it also, of course, to Nicky Hayden. And now he's going to do it again to Jorge Lorenzo. You're probably nothing Jorge Lorenzo could do. We ride with him. Watch this Honda go past him.
Like he's standing still. And
no contest.
Not what you want to see if you are Jorge Lorenzo. So, Stoner leads Pedrosa by 1.5 seconds. How much time can Pedrosa claw back? He'll have to do it quickly before Stoner just gets his head down. He's not going to have any slipstream to work with now, Danny Pedrosa. It's all on the power of that Honda, which isn't too shabby, you have to say. Pedrosa just set a new fastest lap, but only 6 thousandths quicker than Stoner on that last one.
Looks like damage limitation for Jorge Lorenzo. He'll be chasing another podium finish to defend that 63-point lead in the championship. But can Danny Pedrosa start closing the gap on Casey Stoner at the front?
On board now with Danny Pedrosa, climbing up the hill all the way through this section into turn 5. And then it's a kink through turn 6 and tighter turn 7. They have to line the exit up from this one well to get good drive down towards, well, this is the top of the hill, down towards turns 8 and 9, the arrogant corkscrew, as we've dubbed it. It plunges down the hill here, right and then left, the opposite way around to the corkscrew at Laguna Seca. Not quite as dramatic as that corner.
They go up to the top end of the circuit. That's the gap from the helicopter. Pedrosa certainly has got away. The gap between Stoner and Pedrosa, 1.5. So, in fact, through the third split, let's have a look.
Yep.
Yeah, it's pretty constant at the moment, isn't it?
Exactly what Stoner would like to see. And at the moment, he looks to be in good shape. Had a moment there in warm-up where he just dropped the front, and it was such an odd crash. Can't really quite see. As soon as he perhaps touched the front brake, the front washed away. No warning whatsoever for him.
Onto the back straight. Now, this is where Pedrosa has held the advantage over the last three laps, getting past, of course, Lorenzo, getting past Nicky Hayden, and also getting past Ben Spies. So he may close up a little bit. He has about 0.2 seconds, and that splits halfway down the straight, isn't it?
Yeah, and he's making up a lot of time on that straight, Danny Pedrosa. That's where the Honda is so strong. That engine is working well. And to say that he's only just taken his fifth engine this weekend, Danny Pedrosa. Still got another one in the bag. Most of them, okay, have an engine remaining, but all of Pedrosa's still available, where Stoner's got three written off.
It's an all-Italian battle between Marco Simicelli and Andrea Dovizioso for sixth place.
I think Rossi,
Hector Barber, yeah, got past Rossi.
Rossi is behind Hector Barber. Not massively surprised with the way Rossi's been riding. It's not been an easy weekend, but there must have been some kind of mistake for him to lose so much ground so suddenly. Around the outside, Valentino Rossi will take the inside line to go back in front and into eighth position, but there must have been a moment there for the reigning world champion.
Certainly was. He just got a glimpse there behind them of Randy Depunier and Alvaro Bautista. not happy days of Valentino Rossi. That shoulder injury causing him problems. And here comes Andrea Dovizioso, so he'll be desperate to get past Marco Simicelli. Started from the third row of the grid, and he's made progress, but not perhaps the progress he would have wanted to.
You know, it's not all over for third. Nicky Hayden has closed the gap to Jorge Lorenzo. It was at 0.6 on the last lap. It's now, when they're about to come through the third split, it's 0.2. Nicky Hayden is closing all the time on Jorge Lorenzo. And we were talking about Lorenzo earlier on this morning, about him struggling for the podium here, because it's just, well, the Yamaha is not finding this circuit to its liking.
Well, if it happened, it would be the first time Jorge Lorenzo was off the podium this season. It would be the first time Nicky Hayden was on the podium.
And you know what? It would also just create a seed of doubt in his head, wouldn't it?
It would.
Well, just down here in pit lane now with Ducati team boss Vito Guerreschi. Vito, fantastic start for Casey Stoner, but there's got to be some questions about tyre durability in these conditions.
Yeah, it's, the first day is hot. And we hope everybody, the tire arriving the finish in good condition. Sure, the last 5 or 6 laps is very hard for the rider, for the tire.
And what about Nicky Hayden? He's pushing for third now, but he looked like he could pull out one fast lap during practice in qualifying, but not string many together. Are the conditions going to allow him to be a bit more consistent in the race now?
Yeah, sure, the rhythm is very quickly now. The first 5 lap is approximately 150, 149, and I think this is the rhythm.
Okay, thanks, Vito.
Well, on that last lap, the rhythm was great from Stoner, yeah. Just a tenth quicker than Pedrosa. He's reacted to the pressure. Nicky Hayden still on the back of Jorge Lorenzo. They can see, look, a tenth quicker than Pedrosa, half a second quicker than Jorge Lorenzo. Lorenzo's not at the races today, unfortunately. There is Pedrosa still closing down the gap to Casey Stoner, but it's now at 1.5 seconds and not getting any closer.
Long, long way to go. Still 17.5 laps to go here at Aragon. This is proving a very interesting race. Nicky Hayden, there he is as we ride with Jorge Lorenzo. At the front, Casey Stoner setting a searing pace, but Danny Pedrosa, the man in form and full of confidence, and there's still such a long way to go.
Every time I see that onboard camera, I think the bike's gone. I think it's crashed out, because it just seems as we're used to the one on the back where the camera tips and suddenly the bike's on its side and you're thinking, oh, he's gone that. No, he hasn't actually. It's a gyroscopic camera. Someone in Italy's got one of those. When Valentino Rossi finished the race last time out in Misano, he was mobbed, wasn't he, by the crowd. Well, when he got back to the garage, it was sans gyroscopic camera. Someone, I don't know where you're going to be able to use or sell that. It's a memento anyway. Anyone knows, just let us know.
Ben Spies, we've hardly mentioned him after the first few laps. He's having a very good ride in fifth place. Andrea Dovizioso has now got in front of Marco Simicelli.
He didn't take that first couple of corners too well, though, that time. And Dovizioso through, and now closing him down very quickly indeed.
It's Alvaro Bautista, we saw Hector Barbera, Marco Melandri, Aleix Espargaró, Luca Callao, Horacio Armas, Colin Evans having a really tough time at the back of the field at the moment.
It's not easy for the Yamahas here, I have to say, and Edwards has struggled with pace all weekend, and he's probably just struggling to keep in front of riders on the straights. Well, I mean, Lorenzo's struggling, Rossi in eighth, that speeds in fifth at the moment. It's not an easy weekend for them.
The battle for 10th place between Alvaro Bautista and Randy Depruniere. Again, making a decent fist of it, Alvaro Bautista, the sole representative of Suzuki this weekend, without Loris Caparossi not here.
At the front, it's very interesting. Trading lap times at the moment, Stoner and Pedrosa. Hayden's pace just dropped slightly below that of Lorenzo's. It's 0.6 the gap between the Spaniard and the American at the moment in the battle for the final podium position. And the gap between Stoner and Pedrosa still stays at 1.5 seconds. On board now with Casey Stoner. I'm glad he's got a new set of leathers after the crash this morning. Saw him slide about 200 metres down the track. And it's
well, he had no bottom left in it, didn't
he? Yeah, I was trying to think of the most polite way to put that. Yeah,
he certainly did. Oh, Stoner really on the scent of that first Grand Prix victory of the season. That last one was almost a year ago in Malaysia.
It would mean so much to him and the team. After all the problems they've had this season.
You're not going to rule out Danny Pedrosa.
No.
Definitely
a
not.
A long way to go.
No.
16 laps remaining in this race. See, Hayden is still there with Lorenzo, but struggling in some of the corners there too. I mean, that Yamaha is so good in the corners. It just looks like it's on rails, isn't it?
Well, Lorenzo will be looking for those, 18 championship points. He's finishing in third place, so it's very, very important to him. Further down the field, it's Hiroshi Oyama, Mika Kallio, and there is Colin Edwards at the back of this trio. Not easy for him.
If he has signed for Tech 3, like we've heard, a couple of rumours flying around the paddock earlier on, you think he'd... Well, no, you know he's always going to be giving 100%, but... I just think he wants to be a bit higher. And obviously, he goes through now on Hiroshi Oyama. He wouldn't want to be battling with Kallio and Oyama, that's sure. I wonder if he had a problem, actually, in the early stages to have dropped right to the back.
Yeah. Didn't seem too smooth there either, did he, for poor Colin? That was obviously a major problem, but he's now fighting to get past Mika Kallio.
He's very good in that first section of track, and it's probably the case that he's getting past people, and then by the time they get down the back straight, he can't stay ahead of them.
Up over the top through 10 and 11, this is Mika Kallio. Colin Edwards and Hiroshi Oyama. 14th place, Mika Kallio, as it stands at the moment.
Stoner lost another couple of tenths to Pedrosa down the straight, but he'd already pulled out another couple of tenths in the first split, so it's status quo.
Yeah, it's hard for Casey Stoner at the front, knowing Pedrosa will swap lap times with him throughout. It's what you do when you're leading a Grand Prix race, but really been put under pressure.
Now, a big response from Danny Pedrosa. All of a sudden, a 149.567, the fastest lap by a couple of tenths there. That's an impressive lap from Pedrosa. If he can keep churning these out, he'll be back on the rear of Stoner very quickly.
That is a very fast lap indeed from Pedrosa. Second in the championship, he's won those last two races in Indianapolis and in Misano. He is the man in form. Injury free, that's so important for him.
It's back out to 1.5 seconds. Stoner's quicker in the first section, but it's on the straighty bits, isn't it? On the straights where Honda has really pulled all the stops out now.
This will be very interesting. 14 and a half laps to go. Casey Stoner chasing that first win of the season. Danny Pedrosa, what is fifth win of the season?
There's Danny Pedrosa's team just watching on from pit lane. Nothing they can do now. And Stoner's lost another couple of tenths. Back to 1.3 now. That's what it was across the line. And there you can see the big gap on the last lap. Over a quarter of a second between the two of them. Pedrosa is charging.
And that wasn't on the straighty bits, as you call them, was it? Yeah. This is the straighty bit
well,
coming
is,
up now.
It is the engine, though, isn't it? Yes, coming out of 10 and 11.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
Very, very hard through there. Now down the straight. They come across. Third split any moment now. On board with Casey Stoner. What's the gap? 1.1. Yeah, it's closing. It's seriously closing now.
He's starting to put the pressure on.
It's not Stoner slowing down, though. He's just under 149.9 again. He's still pulling out the fast lap times. Just Pedrosa's going even quicker.
I think the crowd are picking up those race times as well. They're urging on Casey Stoner. 14 laps to go here in Aragon. It's round 13 of the championship. Stoner chasing his first win of the season. Now coming under pressure from the man in form on that Repsol Honda, Danny Pedrosa. Nicky Hayden still in fourth place behind the championship leader, Jorge Lorenzo. Fastest lap of 149.521 now for Danny Pedrosa. It just appears that everything Casey Stoner does. Danny Pedrosa just the last couple of laps has gone and leaving a little bit quicker. Nicky Hayden has not let Jorge Lorenzo get away. Can he finish on the podium? It would be the first time that Jorge Lorenzo has finished off the podium for the last 13 races. 12 this season, one last year at Valencia in Spain. We ride with Jorge Lorenzo. There is Nicky Hayden. So through 10 and 11, down towards turn 12. It's a fascinating battle. Casey Stoner, this is where he went down in the morning warm-up. He's through to 13, 14, up to 15, onto that back straight.
And this is where he's going to just take more time, isn't he, now? coming down here, 0.8 the gap. Down they come. What will it be when they go through the third split now? Stoner, the question is as well, can he react? Well, it's 0.9 now, so Stoner's pulled something out there. Pedrosa perhaps not getting things quite right coming out of 15. A few wobbles on the front there from Stoner, but seemingly under control around the final corner into the home straight once more. Can he react? That's the big question.
Well, that's one place catching him up. Another place actually getting past him would not be easy, though he has got that extra speed as they go into turn one. 13 laps to go here at Aragon, and Hayden is closing up on Lorenzo in this battle for the final podium position.
Again, he runs it deep though in turn one, but he brings it around tight. Hayden's closing in, won't make a move just yet, but surely he'll be on Lorenzo's rear soon, trying to make some kind of move. Just behind them, Ben Spies as well, just having a look at him, 1.4 now the gap. He's similar pace to Hayden at the moment, and Andrea Dovizioso not out of this one. This could really bunch up towards the end in the final podium position battle. There's Marco Simoncelli ahead of Valentino Rossi in eighth place.
Yeah, great pals off the track, but they probably didn't realise they'd be racing against each other in the MotoGP race quite as quickly as this. Valentino Rossi and Marco Simoncelli. Give Simoncelli a great thrill, this would, if he could beat Valentino Rossi.
I'm telling you how Casey Stoner's reacted. The gap between Stoner and Pedrosa now 1.1. He's pulled it out again. He's having a superb ride here, the Australian. Now that's Melandri going through on Randy de Pounier. And does the Frenchman come back at him in turn two? No. That's where he went down this morning, de Pounier, and crashed with cold tyres. So, Stoner down the back straight now. Let's have a look through here. Back to a second. On that last lap, there's nothing to choose much between them. But Stoner on this lap certainly seems to have reacted.
Well, what a way to react from Casey Stoner, because Danny Pedrosa has been reeling off those record laps, but he's fought back as they come into the start and finish straight. 12 laps to go of this 23-lap race, and it's over a second as they go over the line.
Stoner's just done a 1:49.6, his personal best lap of the race. He's pulled that one out of the bag. Pedrosa, 1:49.8. We saw his board, his team showing him that board. They've got T, 1:49.8. So they're basically saying that's the pace you need to go at to challenge Stoner. But if Stoner keeps pulling out 1:49.6s, which I don't think he will be able to do consistently, then it wouldn't happen. But Stoner's been in the 1:49.9s for the most of this race.
I'm going to stick my neck out a little bit there, Gav. We know those Ducatis that normally can run a softer compound with no problems. And with Tao, we're definitely looking an issue here now. And with them on the extra hard tyre like everybody else, I think we're going to see Stoner and also Hayden maintain those laps through to the end now.
Well, let's hope they do, in a way. It'd be nice to have a non-Spanish picture of a race, wouldn't it? It'd be nice to see Casey Stoner rewarded for all his hard work. A great corner, isn't it, coming through there?
That's 11, isn't it, as they dive down towards turn 12.
Look how blind it is in there. Yeah. Look how blind.
The cars run straight on there, don't they, onto the back straight. But the bikes have to be slowed down as they're being done. So at the moment, we arrive at Danny Pedrosa. That is the race leader, Casey Stoner, in front of him as they plunge into turn 15.
You know what? He's pulling them back out again. 1.3 seconds now, the gap between Stoner and Pedrosa. He's reacted superbly. Down that straight, 1.6. So he's opened up on this lap, 6 tenths so far. Is Pedrosa beaten?
Just over 11 laps remaining. I don't know about that, but what a response from the Australian in the last throes of his career with Ducati, because he won them the world title in 2007.
Talking about whether he can churn out those laps again, another personal best lap from Stoner, 1:49.5 this time. Ben Spies in turn has set his personal best, and he's close right in on the back of Nicky Hayden, but Hayden is still on the tail of Jorge Lorenzo.
As Valentino Rossi has now got in front of Marco Simoncelli, so Rossi now up into seventh place. Simoncelli has been relegated to eighth.
This was at the end of the last lap, and Valentino Rossi coming along, and this is where we thought most of the overtaking would happen at this circuit. And it seems to be, actually, in other places they've tried. They've tried to surprise each other, I think.
And I think getting into turn one like that, you take problems into turn two, don't you, at the right-hander. So, well, Rossi's made it stick.
Look at that on the last lap, 0.624. Stoner quicker than Pedrosa. And Pedrosa's again losing another tenth at the start of this. This is a great reaction from the Ducati rider. Hasn't been able to show this kind of form, well, since the first five laps in Qatar, really.
Yeah, started the race in pole position. We thought this is going to be a foretaste of the season that lies ahead, and it really went wrong from there, didn't it?
Yeah, remember, Rossi was quickest in all the pre-season testing, apart from the final test at Qatar, when Stoner was quickest, and we thought, OK, it's going to be between these two yet again, with occasional appearances from Lorenzo and Pedrosa. How wrong could we have been, looking back 12 races down? Stoner and Rossi are actually battling for third in the championship.
Yeah, 10 and a half laps ago, 1.1 second, almost 1.2 for Casey Stoner.
Having to fight with the bike coming out of turn 10.
Well, tyre wear is going to play such a big part in this, isn't it? 1.173.
Right, suddenly down to 1.1. It suddenly dropped by 0.6. That moment for Stoner, or some moment in the middle of that lap, and he suddenly dropped 0.6 of a second. And Pedrosa is back on the rear of him.
It's swaying to and fro. Look at Nicky Hayden with Jorge Lorenzo.
It's as though Hayden, throughout the lap, loses a bit of time, makes it up in the second half of the lap, and then Lorenzo just pulls it back out. And all the while,
Spies and Dovizioso, yeah, they're joining in the fun.
Spies is a second behind Hayden. Dovizioso 1.2 behind Spies.
Nicky Hayden lining up Jorge Lorenzo, really just trying to seek out a place and make his move at the right time.
Stoner's refound his mojo on that first split. It's gone back out to 1.2 seconds. He just needs to make no more mistakes. Can he bring it home and win this one?
9.5 laps to go at Aragon. This is the battle for third place, the final position on the podium between Jorge Lorenzo, not been off the podium all season, and Nicky Hayden not been on the podium all season. But they've got to keep the pace up, because Ben Spies and Andrea Dovizioso are not that far behind.
They seem to have enough in the bag at the moment.
Yeah.
Who went around the outside there from Nicky Hayden. He thought about something, didn't he? There's a tighter line from Jorge Lorenzo, and he'll have to do all that work again. Look at the rear stepping out on that Ducati from Nicky Hayden.
This is a 13 and 14, 15 into the back straight, 9.5 to go.
I just gave Spies a little bit of a hint. There's an opportunity to get close to Nicky Hayden down the straight, in the higher gears perhaps, where that Ducati could have an edge. And under braking, Hayden will close back in on the rear of Jorge Lorenzo.
Brilliant onboard stuff through 16 and 17. This will bring them back into the start and finish straight. 9 laps to go, up towards turn one.
At the front, Stoner 1.3 clear of Dani Pedrosa, and they are 6 seconds ahead of this battle for the final podium position between Lorenzo and Hayden, and then Ben Spies and Dovizioso battling for fifth behind. Can Hayden show the wheel? Can he do something?
Well, you thought about it once, I think, don't you? Was it down at turn 12 on the previous lap? Yeah, staying with Jorge Lorenzo, getting past him, the two very, very different things. Nicky Hayden desperate to get on the podium, especially after that disappointing first Ben, second Ben crash at Misano just 14 days ago. There's Stoner, this is Pedrosa.
Out of turn 9 into 10. Winding on the throttle all the time. It bottoms out there, and then it climbs back upwards for 10 and 11. It's hard to tell. It's a very long corner around here. Full gas through there, down towards turn 12. Is this a moment on a previous lap we're going to see? No. Just a slow motion of Stoner. With the front just a little bit loose coming through there.
It's a classic battle between two riders. They're not actually close to each other, but they're just swapping lap times the whole time, aren't they?
Both very similar styles, these two. Pick that bike up out of the corner early. Wrench that throttle open.
Down the back straight, third split up.
1.4 the gap now. So he's opened it back up again. He's
doing a brilliant
stuff,
job,
but he's managing that lead so well. Hayden, 0.2 behind down the back straight.
16 and 17 into the start and finish. There will be 8 laps remaining when they cross the line. Now there they go. 1.3, well about 1.4 really, isn't it, between Stoner and Pedrosa. Nicky Hayden is just not quite close enough as he'd have, well, have a go at Lorenzo.
It seems the way he's getting closer throughout the lap, and then in this first section, Lorenzo's just able to take enough out of him in one and two. And then through three, up towards left kink of four, and the tighter left of five. That's through turn five, all climbing uphill. This was the start of the race again. Lorenzo got away well, you see. But watch Stoner on the outside. And look at Pedrosa. He's desperate to get to the outside of the track because he knows you need the line that Nicky Hayden has coming across. And there he has a little bit of a moment, doesn't he, Danny Pedrosa? I thought actually it was Nicky Hayden who got too close to him. But no, Pedrosa realised. And yes, he had to bring the bike back across for two. On board now with Ben Spies.
Yeah, there is Nicky Hayden, made a good start from a fourth place. The pole position on that second row. There is Pedrosa. No, it's just a moment for Danny Pedrosa on his own, wasn't it? Look again. Look at the Stoner. The game, of course, is number 69, Valentino Rossi.
Rossi started in seventh, got a decent start, actually. But I reckon he probably run it far too deep in there, and that's why he lost position at the start of the race. Gap through the third split down the back straight, 1.6 again. Stoner pulls out. Behind them, Lorenzo, 7 seconds behind. Hayden still in behind him. Spies a second with Dovizioso. A second behind Hayden in fifth with Dovizioso in sixth. Then it's Rossi, seventh. Simoncelli in eighth. Hector Barbera in ninth spot. Then it's Bautista, 10th. Melandri is in 11th. Espargaró in eighth. And Edwards now in 13th because Randy Depugne has just crashed out of the race. Oyama in 14th. And Mika Kallio in 15th.
Are we preparing ourselves for the first Ducati win of the season? The first win from Casey Stoner. Danny Pedrosa beaten for the first time in three races. Not just yet, but Stoner has responded to everything he has thrown at him as it stands at the moment. It's a great ride by Casey Stoner.
This would be taken so well, wouldn't it, by Ducati? They'd have loved it in Misano. Wasn't to be there. They've loved it any race, of course, this season. Probably most at Qatar, but it hasn't been. There's been those front-end problems throughout. He's back with the 2009 forks again this weekend after experimenting with the Evolution forks for 2011, with the 2010 forks at the beginning of the year. But now he's gone back to what he knows last year. And it seems to be working well with all the adjustments they've made this weekend.
6.5 laps to go, Nicky Hayden. As Andrea Dovizioso starts to put a bit of pressure on Ben Spies, this is the battle for fifth place. Closes up on Ben Spies, Andrea Dovizioso, so the two Americans in a sandwich at the moment.
Dovizioso is going to have a go surely at the end of the back straight now. He's right on the tail of Spies. Spies will know he's there. He'll have seen the wheel of the Italian now. Going down there, surely he can't hold off that Honda. A bit of a wheelie from Dovizioso, won't have helped him on acceleration. As they go down to turn 16 on the brakes, can Dovizioso have it? Spies very, very strong in there and holds off the Italian Dovizioso. Dovizioso on the inside will have to roll off the throttle to allow Spies to cut back in front of him. It will all happen again. Six laps remaining.
Good battle between those two. Nicky Hayden again through that last sector, up through the start and finish, closes up on Jorge Lorenzo, doesn't he?
All those fourth place finishes he had at the beginning of the season. Four in the first five races. Can he find something? Can he make his way through onto the podium? Can Dovizioso get through on Ben Spies in turn?
Five and a half laps to go. This is the battle for the final podium position. Nicky Hayden chasing Jorge Lorenzo, not been off the podium this season. As we say, Nicky Hayden not been on it. And I think at the front, Casey Stoner really is now beginning to put the hammer down at the front.
Yeah, it's gone now. 2.367 the gap between Stoner and Pedrosa. It seems that the Australian has broken the Spaniard and he can possibly cruise his way. 2.6 the gap through the second split. So Stoner looks as though he's finally managed it in the 13th round of this season.
Dovizioso not finding life easy with Ben Spies. He's probably got that extra acceleration, so he's got extra top speed, but Ben Spies really fighting hard to hang on to fifth place for the Italian, who lies third in the championship. Five and a half laps to go as they go down towards turn 15. Surely Dovizioso will have another go down at turn 16.
I think he's a bit too far back
this time.
Maybe no wheelie will help, but into sixth gear he goes. Look at the top speed there. 324, he's up to 326 briefly. I think that's just over 200 miles an hour. At the front, Stoner 3 seconds clear of Dani Pedrosa now. So it's all about the remaining podium position between Jorge Lorenzo and Nicky Hayden.
He's broken him.
Yeah,
it was a brilliant ride because Dani Pedrosa threw everything at him, fastest laps, everything he could do. But Casey Stoner has held firm at the front. This is a good battle. It's also an excellent battle for that racer for the final podium position. Casey Stoner, very, very close now to his first Grand Prix victory of the season. The first since the Malaysian Grand Prix of 2009. Wants to sign off with a flourish at Ducati before he joins Honda next season.
He'll get the board next time round, telling him it's over 3 seconds. He could probably just relax slightly, but he won't want to do too much. Won't want to let that front go just a little bit light. He's had so many problems with it this year. Now, Jorge Lorenzo has pulled the gap on Nicky Hayden to 0.585. So cruel on Hayden if he was unable to get his first podium this season. Looked very strong all weekend, and he's challenged Lorenzo. Just not been able to do anything, though, has he, to get in front of Jorge Lorenzo.
No, I think he had one little look, didn't he?
Oh, there's Miguel Indurain, 5 times Tour de France winner on the right-hand side. He's a big cycling fan, actually, Dani Pedrosa. Has a lot of the MotoGP riders, and I'm sure he'll be pleased to have Indurain in his garage. So I'm sure Ian now will be down to that Repsol Honda garage.
I'll tell you where Ian's gone. Talking about cycling fans.
I'm just down here in the Repsol Honda garage.
Yeah. There he is, he's getting the sign, Dani Pedrosa. 3.2, the gap back to Dani Pedrosa. 4 laps remaining for him to win his first MotoGP race of the season.
Dani Pedrosa, well, he would want to win, of course, but if he can finish in front of Jorge Lorenzo, is Nicky Hayden not giving this one up in the battle for third place? All he can do is try and win races, but actually finishing in front of Jorge Lorenzo, of course, will help him out as Andrea Dovizioso. I'd have said a couple of laps ago he's going to get past Ben Spies. What do I know? Ben Spies is really putting up a good fight. Quite sad to see Valentino Rossi down there. He's probably enjoying himself down in seventh place, fighting with the likes of Marco Simoncelli. This is Hector Barbera trying to find out from Alvaro Bautista in their battle for ninth. Behind them is Marco Melandri.
Well, they had their moments in the 250cc class in the past, these two.
Yeah.
Now Bautista's lining something up through the left kink, perhaps, of turn 4 into 5. No, no chance for him there. This is 9th Barbera, 10th Bautista, and 11th Marco Melandri, and then just behind Aleix Espargaró in 12th. Only one faller so far today, that's Randy Depunier.
And I can tell you, Randy Depunier has just come back to the pit box now. Obviously unhappy with the result today, but completely uninjured in the crash.
That's the main thing, isn't it? Yeah, that's great news. Yeah, these two did have some great battles. Alvaro Bautista and Hector Barbera swapped a bit of paint, swapped a few hand signs at certain times, which probably didn't mean went too polite.
Still, the battle goes on for third as Bautista tries to find a way through at the blind entry to turn 12. Not this time. He's pressurising Hector Barbera. No. Just got Marco Melandri lurking as well to pick up the pieces of any over-exuberant manoeuvre. Well, still Stoner down in the low 150s. Dani Pedrosa 3.8 seconds behind in the 150.8. Lorenzo about to come across the line any moment now. 150.5, Hayden 150.5 as well. 2 tenths separating them.
This is still the battle for ninth place. Hector Barbera into turn 16. Alvaro Bautista and Marco Melandri behind him. 16 and 17.
On board with Hector Barbera, and Marco Melandri's through on Bautista. He says, look, if you're not going to make the move, then I'm going to make one on you. Bautista outbreaks him, though, down into turn one. And will he have the bike in the way in turn two? Yeah, nothing Melandri can do about that. Hayden is right on the rear of Jorge Lorenzo now, but we're riding with the Australian Casey Stoner, who's led this race from the start. Could it be a flag-to-flag victory for Casey Stoner?
Yeah, had to fight for that right, didn't he, in the first two or three bends with Jorge Lorenzo. But he got there. And this is Casey Stoner of old. And Ducati of old in many, many ways. But Nicky Hayden is closing on Jorge Lorenzo 2.5 laps ago. What a celebration it would be for Ducati if Nicky Hayden put it on the podium.
Through the last split, Hayden was alongside Lorenzo. The lap time, the split time, here comes Hayden. He's just looking to go through. Oh, almost went through at 13. Not to be. So into 14 and 15, he's going to make a move before the end of the race. A slight warning for him there. Into 15, down the back straight goes Nicky Hayden. Lorenzo's clinging on to a podium spot. Nicky Hayden is desperate for it.
Down the back straight they go. 2.5 laps to go. That's the gap between them. They now break for 16 and 17. He's had a nibble now, Nicky Hayden.
A couple.
He?
He's had a he's couple had a of
He's going to have another go at Jorge Lorenzo.
Very good coming out of that last corner there, Nicky Hayden. You get good drive down towards turn one. Not close enough, though, to make a move. Behind Andrea Dovizioso thinks one more time about going through, but Ben Spies quickly puts all thoughts out of his head.
Two laps to go. Ben Spies has done a brilliant job with Andrea Dovizioso. He's hanging in there at the moment. Now how's Nicky Hayden doing his Spies? Still fights off Andrea Dovizioso. Stoner leads. Pedrosa in second place. 1.5 laps to go here at Aragon. Could we see two Ducatis on the podium for the first time this season?
So we're watching Spies battling for fifth place with Andrea Dovizioso. Just catch Nicky Hayden in the foreground there, right on the tail of Jorge Lorenzo, on board now with Andrea Dovizioso, heading towards turns 8 and 9, plunging downhill. Dovizioso takes a tighter line, trying to get the drive out of here, out of 9, then into 10. Through the gears they go, it bottoms out there, and then they climb up the hill through turn 11.
Up over the rise from turn 11, they plunge downhill now towards turn 12, the left-hander. Spies has made life so, so difficult for Andrea Dovizioso. 12, 13 coming up. Dovizioso desperate to get past the rookie of the year in Ben Spies. Down towards 14, and then the left 15 that brings them into the back straight. 1.5 laps to go here at Aragon.
Very tight between these two in this battle for fifth place. Jorge Lorenzo still keeping Nicky Hayden at bay in front with just a lap to go. And now, finally, Dovizioso gets the run on Spies. Down towards 16, but Spies will be strong on the brakes. Here he comes again around the outside. Brilliant defence from Spies, but this time forced to run it too deep in the corner. What about the drive down the home straight? He picks it up lovely out of there, Ben Spies, almost alongside Dovizioso. Down towards turn one, will Spies respond? He does. Goes on the inside of Dovizioso, back into fifth place.
Can he make it stick as they flick it right into turn two? Whoa, just fills up the space. Andrea Dovizioso wanted to go through. This is the battle for fifth place, and Ben Spies holds the advantage with 3/4 of a lap to go.
Still Stoner leads from Pedrosa. Still Lorenzo hangs on to third ahead of Nicky Hayden. There is Stoner leading, but Hayden is closing once more. It's down to under 0.3. Between Hayden and Lorenzo in the battle for the podium spot. Stoner leading the way, though. 5 seconds clear of Danny Pedrosa. He will take Ducati's first victory of the season. Pedrosa in second, a lonely ride now for him. 5 behind Stoner, 5 ahead of Lorenzo. This is Nicky Hayden behind Jorge Lorenzo. They're coming out the fast turn 10 through 11, down towards turn 12, where he had a nibble a couple of laps ago.
We ride with Jorge Lorenzo. Look out for that red Ducati on the outside or the inside. He's not close enough this time round. Half a lap left for Nicky Hayden as he chases that first podium finish of the season. Can he knock Jorge Lorenzo off the podium for the first time this season? He has half a lap.
And here he comes through into turn 15. Nicky Hayden's going to stand it up in front of Jorge Lorenzo. He will get the drive down the back straight. Here comes Hayden. Can Lorenzo do anything to fight back?
Celebration time at Ducati. Casey Stoner's going to win the race. Who's going to finish in second place? They dive into turn 16. Hayden holds the advantage. Casey Stoner wins here in Aragon.
Stoner wins the race. Pedrosa will take second, but can Nicky Hayden make it a great day for Ducati? He does do. Nicky Hayden takes his first podium of the season. Brilliant stuff ahead of Jorge Lorenzo, who misses out on the podium for the first time this year. Ben Spies in fifth, and have we lost Andrea Dovizioso?
Yep.
We lost him halfway through that last lap.
Dovizioso's gone. So Ben Spies in fifth place. That's the first time Jorge Lorenzo has not finished on the podium this season. Valentino Rossi finishes sixth in front of his great friend Marco Civitelli.
Oh, Bautista's one out. Oh, he takes eighth ahead of Marco Melandri. And then in ninth is
Hector Barbera,
yes. And this was Andrea Dovizioso. Oh, it's in turn 12, 13.
Yeah, 12 and 13. That, with the wall.
Right, a left-right complex. Well, what a dramatic last lap. A great day for Ducati. First and third for them. And there is Dovi walking away from that one. I would obviously haven't seen what's happened.
Right, I'm just down here with a very, very happy looking Vito Guerrucci. First win for Ducati this season. First podium for Nicky Hayden. Your first win as team manager with the team, if I remember rightly. Happy days.
Yes, yeah, fantastic. Unbelievable. To bike up the podium is incredible. And after the first part of the season like this, it's a dream.
Well, congratulations for today, Vito.
Only the start.
Thanks very much.
Yeah, shame it couldn't have been like this from the start of the year for them. It'd be great to see that the Ducati's up with the Hondas and the Yamaha, but Stoner's done the business, hasn't he, in front of the Spanish fans. The run of Spanish wins, which went all the way back to Jerez early on in this year, is broken here at Aragon. Valentino Rossi, the last non-Spanish winner in MotoGP. And that was in the opening race of the season.
Didn't he throw everything at him, Danny Pedrosa? And Casey Stoner just matched him lap for lap.
Well, it's obvious Aragon works for the Ducati. Yeah. Casey Stoner, he didn't say he didn't like it, didn't say he was a big fan of this circuit, but I'm sure he'll love Aragon now when he leaves tonight.
Oh, what a different journey home this will be for Nicky Hayden after disappointments 14 days ago in Misano. Crashed out on the second bend of the race. A podium finish at last for the former world champion. And this is how it happened.
And how much he deserves it. You really have to say, and he just blocked past there, didn't he? Yeah. In the second, in the exit from turn 15, put the bike there, nothing Lorenzo could do. Wheelies out of the corner, but just watch this. He just carries a lot more speed out of the corner and fires it onto the inside. That's where Lorenzo wants to be. Lorenzo will just see him now, see the front wheel there. We'll try and bring it round, but Hayden's bike's in the way. And you can see the team look on. They've lost out. And Hayden made the move, it stuck. And you can't say fairer than that. It was a great manoeuvre. In the championship, it makes it a bit more interesting.
Yes, it does.
Because Lorenzo loses a couple more points to Danny Pedrosa. So the gap between them at the top now stands at 56 points.
It's still in five rounds, it's still for him to lose. If Danny Pedrosa had won the race, it may have been a little bit different, but nobody was going to beat Casey Stoner today. Honda will be rubbing their hands in some ways, won't they?
That bike looks fantastic,
yeah, it does.
I have to say. Well, the Ducati's winning again, and I'm sure Valentino Rossi won't be too displeased to see that. A few snipes from him about Stoner wasn't pushing the bike quite hard enough. Well, today he'll have seen Stoner really did push it to the absolute limit. He'll deserve all the plaudits he gets today, Casey Stoner.
Yeah, he did grande, he certainly did. And Danny Pedrosa will be disappointed, but he gave it all he had and he's still picked up 20 points and he's in a good run of form, a second, two firsts and a second. That's all Valentino Rossi could hope for, I think, isn't it? And he's put in a good effort, put in a good stint.
Wave to the cameras, his worst result of the season.
Great ride by Ben Spies, and he called Andrea Dovizioso to crash. So not caused him in a bad way, but just would not give up that place, would he? Confirmation of what Gavin said, 56 points between Lorenzo Pedrosa. Stoner moves up two places to third. Valentino Rossi in fourth place.
I'm just down here now with a man who's probably battling harder than anybody on track today. Ben Spies, that fifth place was yours and you weren't going to give it up today, were you?
Yeah, I wasn't giving that away after staying there for so long. Dovi rode a great race. He caught up to the back of me. We had a hellacious battle the last two laps, and it all started off the back straightaway. We went back and forth, and then he passed me in turn 8. I kind of retaliated back in turn 11 and ran a little wide and got to the next corner before him, and I think he was trying to drive it around the outside of me on a little momentum and just lost the front. I barely caught it at the corner of my eye that I saw him crash and knew I had fifth in. But yeah, we both were fighting tooth and nail for that last fifth place for sure.
Well, congratulations on a great battle and a great race today, Ben.
Thank you.
nice there, wasn't it? Stoner went over, congratulating Hayden's half of the squad, and Nicky Hayden, of course, as well.
Yeah, it was okay. At the front, it was an interesting battle, they never got close enough, but behind them, two great battles, Hayden Lorenzo and Spies and Davizioso.
Now watch this, this was Lorenzo knowing that he didn't quite have the pace, fired it on the inside of Stoner, but watch Stoner react. That's a really, really good start to the race, wasn't it? As it went through turn five.
Yeah, dead right. Lorenzo knew that he had to do something early on because if Stoner got away, which he did. Stoner also knew he wasn't going to get involved in that. He wanted to get to the front. He had his mate just behind him as well, Nicky Hayden.
And it stayed like that behind Lorenzo, didn't it, till the end of the race, the very last lap, when he managed to put the bike in front of Jorge Lorenzo. Ben Spies, as we just heard from him, fifth place, not a bad result, I would say, ahead of Valentino Rossi, I think would be his aim every single week.
A very good result, and what they did was make a very exciting race. The two Americans actually providers, there was some great excitement, didn't there?
It's quite a good battle for sixth in the championship between those two now. 6 points between Spies and Hayden. Hayden, of course, just clawing back a couple of points then to Ben Spies after that result. These are confirmation of those results. Stoner wins his first race of the season. Danny Pedrosa in second. Nicky Hayden takes third. And Jorge Lorenzo off the podium. His run of 13 consecutive podiums from Valencia last year comes to an end finally.
Five rounds to go for Jorge Lorenzo. You think he would be safe and sound, but there would just be a few little doubts.
You know what, actually, he won't be too displeased that Stoner's in there mixing it up as well, because, I'm not sure. I think, actually, just the way things are, only Lorenzo and Pedrosa now can win the championship. Yep. 125 points still up for grabs, and you see he's 129 ahead of Casey Stoner. So only Lorenzo Pedrosa can win. So if Stoner can keep getting ahead of Pedrosa, then there's less of a gap there.
Good battle for third place. Could go anyway, though. Got to say, the man that's flying at the moment, of course, is Casey Stoner after that first Grand Prix victory. The Loris Caparossi, you see, not racing here this weekend, down in 15th place, but he will return the Japanese Grand Prix at Motegi in 1-1. Golly, I hope not. 2 weeks' time.
Going to say, I'll see you there the week after.
Yeah. We don't want any ash cloud, do we?
No, not this time. Álvaro Bautista actually moves ahead of Loris Caparossi. Now, they were level on points before this race began, but now he's comfortably ahead of him after eighth place today. His third eighth place in a row, actually.
Here we are, Parc Fermé, two Ducatis with a Honda sandwiched in the middle.
Haven't seen that for a while, have we?
No, we certainly haven't. Casey Stoner doing his television interviews. Well, it was round 13 in the championship. I tell you what, it was unlucky for some and lucky for others, wasn't it? So everybody now beginning to make their way home. I tell you what, they've had a really good day's racing here at Aragon.
Hey, the roads look clear now. If we get away quick,
let's go see you.
We'll go.
I'm not here. I'm gone.
We're not going to get out of here very soon because there's only a couple of roads lead to the circuit, and so I'm assuming only a couple that lead away from it.
Let's
well.
Find some. Like Hector Barbera fastest through the speed trap at 325.9. I like looking at these. I'm never quite sure how important they are, unless there's a really, really big difference, I suppose. I mean, there's
well,
Cassie Stoner won there, yeah. But
yeah, Stoner and Hayden, they're not that much quicker than Lorenzo, no. So that's, you know, there wasn't that opportunity for perhaps for Nicky Hayden to go through at the end of the straight there.
But it's acceleration and different parts of the circuit, so it's not sheer top speed, isn't it?
Well, that's where the Honda looks good, picking up out of corners. And the Yamaha, of course, is just very, very solid in the corners. It's intriguing.
Well, anyways, it's a good bike to defend the championship lead, the Yamaha, as you say. It's really solid, and that's what probably Jorge Lorenzo needs to be. But five races in 6 weeks coming up. Is it all over? Well, you'd think it may be, but Danny Pedrosa maybe to exert a bit of pressure on the techie a couple of weeks' time. And of course, now the boys in red are back, aren't they? And they're not going to give up.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Stoner's going to be strong in Australia, for example. He has been for the last couple of years. And in Japan, Ducati generally goes well. Honda will obviously go well there. Yamaha, I think they fancy a new engine there, perhaps. And Alessandro Cicognani on the right. He's in charge of their MotoGP project.
Well, they've put a lot of commitment, a lot of effort, and obviously a lot of sponsors' money into their MotoGP program next season. And this is just the sort of result you need when you've made that commitment, isn't it?
There you can see the king, Juan Carlos, just chatting with Nicky Hayden and Alessandro Cicognani, then Danny Pedrosa. Big smile to him. Look at that. That's human touch, isn't it, really?
Yeah. He knows he's racing, doesn't he?
Yeah. Well, you could see he was probably saying to Nicky Hayden, you took my Spaniard off the podium, but well done to you. That's nice. He hasn't been well, so good to see him at the races. I think his first private, it's actually a private visit, but it's his first official engagement for quite a few months. So it's special that it's MotoGP. The first race here at Aragon, of course, as the riders step onto the podium.
And it's almost a year since we saw Casey Stoner on that top step. It was Malaysia 2009. He's back on the top step. He's won here at Aragon.
So the Vice President of the Regional Government presents Nicky Hayden with his first trophy of 2010, and he has thoroughly deserved that one. Not been on the podium since Indianapolis last year, so it's over a year.
Big thumbs up from Nicky Hayden. Danny Pedrosa obviously wants to win the race, but he's in great form. It's what, the last four races, 2 seconds and two thirds. Listen to the crowd. There's nothing more he could have done, is there? I think that if you know that, you can't worry about it.
There'll be no complaints from his team, that's for sure.
Nor from him.
Now to collect the trophy as the winner in the A-Star Grand Prix of Aragon from His Royal Highness, the King of Spain. And the winner of the first Grand Prix here at the new Motorland Aragon circuit. It's Australia's Casey Stoner.
Stoner's back, Ducati are back, and for the first time this season, it's going to be the Australian national anthem.
Just get the presentation to Ducati.
Yep.
Their first constructor's trophy of the season to Alessandro Cicognani. That's for the team from Juan Moretta there, the vice president of the FIM. And now we will, as Nick says, get Advance Australia Fair ringing out around the Aragon circuit. Thank you.
Warm round of applause for Casey Stoner. First win of the season, first win for Ducati. The King leaves the podium before the champagne arrives. King and Nicky Hayden exchange notes for a minute. Where did you take him? Oh, right there. That's good. Andy Petrosa wants to know as well.
What happened?
What happened to Andrea Dovizioso, he's probably asking as well. Still no sign of the champagne.
They usually store it. They usually store it outside our room, don't they?
We could have some a couple of bottles away.
Naughty MotoGP rider might soak him. Sort of thing they do, isn't it? Maybe not these, because these are the three of the most pleasant characters there is in MotoGP. There they go. They celebrate with the champagne. Nicky Hayden gets to enjoy it for the first time this year. And Casey Stoner enjoy it as the first winner. First time as a winner, should I say.
Yeah. Tell you what, it's been waiting quite a long time, that champagne. It seems really nice and bubbly, doesn't it? Yeah, special day for Ducati. Noel Lorenzo left the garage quite quickly, don't you think?
Yeah, so he won't be happy.
No, he won't.
But you bet your bottom dollar he will be back out there. Things just the last couple of races not been so easy for Jorge Lorenzo. Of course, Pedrosa won the last two before here. And before that, Lorenzo's last win in Brno.